Hey, welcome back to Blog While I Game with Heretic. I am Rhiannon Rose. I haven't started playing just yet because I have to pick out the music for today. We're gonna go with more dark techno. Because the music on the level that I'm on right now sucks. And dark techno music is, it's pretty good music for playing a first-person shooter with. I'm back at the beginning of this level. I hate this level. I knew I was on this level because that's why I was picking the music for this level instead of using the in-game music, because I hate the music on this level. It's really stressful on a really stressful level, but like I didn't realize that I was back at the beginning of it. What do we want to talk about today? I know that Christo-fascists are ruining America with anti-trans genocide, and Britain's got its problems too. I'm kind of tired of talking about that though. Life goes on. For those of us who are in safer places anyway. And safer is all relative when you're trans. You can be in a state that affirms trans rights, and there are still transphobically violent people. Anyway, life goes on for all of us, right? None of the things that we would be talking about if we didn't have to address the horrendous situations in America and Britain right now, none of that goes away just because fascists are being shitty, right? Yes, I just cheated. Bite me. I should really have more weapons than that at this point in the game. Yeah, anyway. So what do we want to talk about today? I've been spending a few days just, like, recouping on Twitter. I don't know why I spent my time recouping on Twitter, because it's not as recuperative if I do that. But that's where I've been spending my time. My time off from doing Blog While I Game that I had for a little bit while I was just like too morosely depressed for a few days. I sat in front of the computer for like 3 hours trying to find the motivation and was like, nope, too depressed. So, time recuperating from blogging about Christo-fascists ruining America and TERFs ruining Britain and, we've spent plenty of time talking about that, and in the meantime, while, like, we're sort of in between horrific genocidal things happening, life continues. So let's talk about all the things that we would ordinarily talk about. Let's talk about one of the things that I saw some people talking about on Twitter the other day. the whole conversation of like, wait, who fucks trans people? Do I have to fuck a trans person? What? What are you saying? Like, okay. No one said that. And you don't. There's a conversation that happens every now and then when transphobic people want to try to say it's not transphobic to call a trans woman a man or a trans man a woman. And that's very clearly transphobic. What they're really trying to say is that what they're really trying to say is that transphobia isn't real because trans people aren't real. We're some unnatural abomination. And so they don't have to respect the rules of treating human beings like human beings. It is just so important to them in the face of all this insanity going on that they be able to misgender trans people. Because what if they weren't able to misgender us? Oh my gosh, they might have to date one of us? No, actually, not even. Like, okay, here's my 2 cents to the whole, like, who dates trans people? Are you saying that I have to date a trans person or I'm transphobic conversation? Because it's a really insincere conversation in the first place. The people who started this conversation strictly out of a desire to misgender trans people. It's a hypothetical conversation that just like centers around the ability of transphobic people to just misgender a trans person with impunity. Yeah, so like, oh my gosh, like, but what if a trans person actually approached you? None of the transphobic people on the side of this conversation have been approached by a trans person to date them, by the way. Because if they had, we wouldn't be having this conversation. It's all hypothetical. And it's very loaded. Let's see. So what if a trans person came up to you and wanted to date you, and you were like, oh no, your genitals are icky. I think your genitals are icky. Like, okay, well, you might be making an assumption about what genitals they have, but, you know, yeah. Let's say you feel like their genitals are icky, and they have the genitals that you think they have, and you think those genitals are icky. Okay. You can say no thank you. Wow, I know, shocking, you can say no. Like, shockingly enough, for experiencing disproportionately high rates of sexual violence, trans people are pretty aware that consent is king, and pretty consent-minded, and you can just say no. You can say no thank you. That's fine. I don't care what your reason is. It can be because of a body part. I don't care, that's fine. You're allowed for any reason you want to not want to fuck someone, even if it's like, oh, I think a body part is icky and this person's body part icks me out. Yeah. You can absolutely not consent for that reason. You can not consent just for any reason because you don't want to. Like, duh. However, what you don't have to do in the process is dehumanize someone by misgendering them. You don't have to call a trans woman a man are a trans man, a woman, and can we talk about specifically about calling trans men women for a second, like calling people who were assigned female at birth women, because like some transphobic people try to get like really really creative with how they go about on their dating profiles saying that they're transphobic without just outright, you know, making it completely obvious that they're transphobic. What they'll do is they'll be like, AFAB bodies only. And I guarantee you, every one of these people that has a profile that's like AFAB bodies only started at women only. And then just lumped in a bunch of men and non-binary people because they happen to have a vagina, and that's fucking gross. What a really fancy way to misgender trans men and non-binary people who were assigned female at birth. I want potions that I can't find any. They're all in the river of lava. Oops. That was Rings of Invincibility. Oh well. That was Shadow Spheres. Oops. Yeah, just ew. And like that quote unquote AFAB body that trans man has is probably really different than the AFAB body of like a cis woman in some ways. And if it's not now, the odds are kind of good that they would prefer if it were. And I've met a lot of trans men who are not necessarily into a lot of the things that, like, a cis woman would be into sexually involving their vagina. Like, how gross of you. And yes, how still transphobic of you. Like, I'm not gonna say that it's necessarily transphobic to like only want to like to only want to be involved with one kind of genitals, like, and to only consent to getting with people of one kind of genitals. Like, just that in and of itself, like, you could have, there's a plethora of reasons that you could have, you know. Hey, I'm really leery about getting with like, specifically with cis women. And it has to do with sexual trauma with a cis woman. Sexual trauma with multiple cis women, in fact. And I've heard people levy sexual trauma as a reason why they're only interested in like one kind of genitals. I understand. Wow. Like, imagine what you can learn when you actually get a trans perspective on the topic. Wow. Like, no, like, however, a lot of people having this conversation are specifically wanting permission to be transphobic about it. Like, they're specifically wanting to be like, hey, I want to say no trannies allowed on my profile, and then, like, act like I'm not being transphobic. You can decline people who are women but have a dick on a case-by-case basis if you don't want to be with a woman with a dick. Like, when you say trannies, and that's a fucking slur, and what you would be trying to say is trans women, and you're like, I'm excluding all these people because they all have a dick, some of those people actually do have a vagina. And if you want to decline them too, well, you're certainly not doing it for them having a dick, you're just doing it for them being trans, and whether it's transphobic or not becomes a moot point when you just realize that you are transphobic anyway. Like, you're the kind of person who calls trans women men. You say trannies because you refuse to say trans women, because you refuse to acknowledge us as women, and it's just another way of saying men. You're the kind of person who lumps men and non-binary people with vaginas in as women. And, like, how gross to, like, act like... Do you really want to fuck everyone who has the kind of genitals that you say that are the exclusive genitals that you're into? Do you really feel sexually attracted to every single one of those people? Because that's fucking gross. That's fucking creepy. That's not okay. That's not normal. And I guarantee you don't. You're not really attracted to every single person with a vagina if vaginas are your thing, or every single person with a dick if dicks are your thing. And if you are, that's fucking gross. It's creepy. And I want you far the fuck away from me. But you can decline those people without being dehumanizing about it. You don't misgender them just because, like, you're into redheads. You don't tell a blonde that she's a man. You don't act all super threatened by a chick in a situation that you wouldn't normally feel all super threatened by a chick. Just because you're into redheads and the chick who wants to ask you for this dance is blonde. Seriously, like, fuck who you want, don't fuck who you don't want. Like... It's not that hard. You don't have to be an asshole about it. I'll never call you an asshole for rejecting a trans person. Until you dehumanize them for it. Until you body shame them for it. Until you call them a man when they're a woman, or a woman when they're a man, until you misgender them, I am not gonna call you an asshole for it. When you do that, yeah, I'm gonna call you an asshole for it. I'm gonna call you an asshole for body shaming anyone to reject them. I'm gonna call you an asshole for misgendering anyone to reject them, but I guarantee you only misgender trans people. And, like, if you're out there misgendering trans people intentionally, like, you're a transphobe. Anyway! Oh my gosh, I recognize this track. I love this track. Where is the damn yellow key? I have used this track before as background music for a photo collage, for like a video photo collage of a photo shoot that I did once. I fucking love this track. This is so soothing. We can just spend forever looking for the yellow key. A ring of invulnerability. I already have like 8 of those. Just gather up everything on the river of lava. The real reason behind this conversation is not like that trans people anywhere are saying that you have to fuck a trans person or else you're a transphobe. Literally no one is saying that. Like, TERFs would love to have you believe that because they're into spreading this whole transmisogynist ideology that they believe that trans women are some mysterious third sex of rapists who won't take no for an answer. You can say no. We will take it for an answer. And people who are just like angry they want to be able to know what genitals everyone has. I'm so done looking for this yellow key. They want to know what genitals everyone has just by looking at them. And it just really makes them angry knowing that they could one day find someone sexually attractive, but then find out that they don't have the genitals they're looking for, and that would just be so much worse than any other deal breaker. Like, those are the people that are like trying to make this such a hot topic. Trans people are mostly just dating other trans people. Trans people are also dating cis people, like, and people are angry about that. And those are the people that want to make this a hot topic also. Like, they're just really miffed. They are so angry knowing that, like, oh my gosh, yes, there are straight men out there hounding trans women. Hounding us with dick pics and unsolicited haze and, like, random comments of like, I sent you a friend request, but I don't think you got it on our public posts. I'm like, oh my gosh, the chasers are like everywhere and like acting like there is no such thing as a lesbian who enjoys dick. Like, the Turf Brigade would love to round up and burn all the cis lesbians' dildos and straps. They really would. Oh my gosh. They get angry that they can't say that a woman who dates a trans woman is not a lesbian. Like, many women date trans women. Many of those women are trans. Many of those women are also cis. They're lesbians. Dating a woman is gay. Like, like, if you're with a woman and you're doing sexy things and it happens to involve dick, and you're still with a woman, that's gay. We didn't used to just declare cis lesbians straight when they busted out a strap-on, but like, then the Turf Brigade came along. And, like, a vast community of lesbians have been like, the TERFs are not, we're not sure what's up with them, but, like, they don't speak for us for a really long time. Like, if you want to have some fun learning about this, look up political lesbianism. Oh, I still have so many potions. Damn dragons. I really hate this level. So I'm using every cheat there is in the book on this level. Like, I really hate this level. I would love for more people to hear the trans side of this conversation, which is just that you can say no. Cis people want to be transphobic, but like, it's kind of difficult to justify when like you talk to an actual trans person and you're like, I don't want to have to fuck you, and we're like, okay, I definitely don't want to fuck you either, bye. Like, oh my gosh, people. It's so ridiculous. Are these the same people that would like that would say that like if a straight couple existed and like the guy let the woman do butt stuff that would make him gay? Are these those same people? Because it definitely feels like it is. Where'd the music go? Did we get to the end of all the dark techno music? Do we have to start over? Ah, shit! I used so much music that you have to attribute for using. You know what though? That's okay. I didn't intend to do that, Kevin MacLeod. You just had a bunch of dark techno songs that were on the list, but thank you for them. They were cool. They were great music to have around for this game. I'm gonna have to attribute every single one of these tracks in this video. Oh my gosh. I didn't intend to do that, but since I did it, let's just start the playlist over. Those probably won't come up for the rest of this video since there's only like a minute left. They probably won't come up through like the entirety of the next video either, but if they're in the list, like, I'm gonna take them out at some point because that's just like so much space to take up with attributions, because that was a lot of Kevin MacLeod music, okay? But oh gosh, just look in the description, look at how many fucking Kevin MacLeod tracks there were! So I might take them out of the list in future. We might not hear them again, but they were nice for this episode. Oh, as always, thank you so very much for watching. And until next time, unless you're a transphobe, be yourself.